Zimbenya, Mabagi, Chihuahua.
Is there an increase in the biodiversity of marine fauna towards the lower intertidal zone of the rocky shores of Bologna, Spain?
Rocky shores. This habitat provides a stable substrate for organisms to colonize in contrast to sandy beach. As you would have seen during our marine day, there is a rich and diverse marine fauna and flora. During the marine day, we noticed that certain areas in the rocky shores we were collecting specimens had a greater abundance of marine species compared to others. We then wondered if this had any significance. We came up with the hypothesis that on the intertidal zone of the rocky shores of Bologna, Spain, the biodiversity of marine fauna increased as you move further towards the sea. The reason for this hypothesis is that we thought that the closer a species is towards the shore, the harsher the conditions for the organism. For example, the further upshore an organism is, the longer it has to survive without water when the tide goes out, which will lead to desiccation and fluctuating temperatures. There is also exposure to fresh water when it rains and a greater chance of their habitat being disturbed by people and animals who pass by. Therefore, it would be more likely that fewer species, the ones with the adaptations for these fluctuating conditions, would be found in the upper shore, and a greater diversity of species towards the lower shore.
The method we used to investigate this hypothesis was by identifying the number of individuals of each species at 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 40 meter, 50 meter, and 60 meter in a 3 meter square quadrant down 6 different transects. To do this, we use basic equipments, measuring tape to measure the distance from the shore, some nets and buckets for catching, counting and identifying species and individuals, field guides and 8 metal pins to make up the 3 meter square quadrant. The first transect was chosen at random in an unbiased manner by one person simply throwing a stick over their shoulder. The following two transects were 40 meter along the shore from each other. On the second day, we used the same method to obtain data from another 3 transects to give us a total of 6 different transects, 36 different sites, and a total area of 108 meters square. We worked together as a group of 4 on each size to reduce the possibility of missing any mobile and fast-moving individuals such as shrimp and crab. We lifted every rock we could and checked through all the seaweeds within our quadrants.
Tabulated the data on Excel to calculate species abundance and total number of individuals at each transect using the formula commands on Excel. We were then able to calculate the value of the Shannon-Wiener Diversity Index, which we used to plot a graph showing Shannon-Wiener Diversity Index against distance from the shore.